Now this next weed, if you have it, whether it's growing in your turf grass or your landscape, you're gonna have a lot of problems, and that is Bermudagrass. So Bermudagrass is one of our worst perennial grass species. It can be used as a turf grass and be used as a pretty desirable turf grass species, but typically when it's used as a turf, it is an improved variety and not common Bermuda, which we have here. So common Bermuda is a perennial grass that's gonna spread in a couple different ways. It can spread by stolons, which you have here, which are the stems that run along the top of the ground. And so each one of these points where these leaves are emerging, it will root down to the ground. So that's one of the ways that it's spreading. It also has rhizomes below the ground, so that's another way that it spreads. So essentially, the things that are making Bermudagrass a very durable turf grass species make it one of the world's worst weeds, and then some people call it the world's worst weed. To identify Bermudagrass compared to some other grasses, it is a very fine leafed grass. So if you look closely at the leaves are very thin, and they're coming out on opposite sides of the stem like you have here. And then it is one that is going to spread throughout. So if it's in landscape beds, typically you're gonna wanna use a non-selective herbicide. Glyphosate is a herbicide that is often recommended, and then other non-selective post-emergence herbicides can possibly control it, but you wanna make sure that they're systemic. Another option in landscape planting beds would be graminicides, which are post-emergence herbicides that only have activity on grass plants. And so a few of those can be effective also. Depending upon what kind of turf grass you have, you're generally not going to have very many options for controlling Bermudagrass. And so it's one of those things where you're going to want to kill basically everything, the Bermudagrass and the turf grass, and go back in and resod or sprig the area to get your desirable turf grass species reestablished again. But one thing you want to keep in mind is no matter what herbicide that you're using to control Bermudagrass, you're generally not going to control it with just one application. And so you want to make sure that it is completely controlled, completely killed, by making possibly two or three applications and waiting to make sure it doesn't come back before you invest the time and energy to go out and resod the area. For more information on weed identification, contact your local University of Florida IFAS Extension Office.